got Jack Stone with us today. How are you, Jack?
Good. How are you, Mr. Miko?
Awesome. Awesome. I appreciate you doing this. And for people that don't know, we're kind of recording this during spring break. So we're in week three of the football season. We've got Crystal Lake Central on the schedule tomorrow, right?
Yes, sir.
So for people, if you want to just take a little bit of time to kind of introduce yourself and just talk about over the last 4 years, what you've been involved in at PR, from athletics to extracurricular to any organizations and stuff, if that works.
Okay. Well, as Mr. Miko just said, I'm Jack Stone. I'm a senior. I've been playing football all 4 years at the same position. I play wide receiver. But other than football, I also do wrestling and baseball. I am an outfielder slash pitcher for baseball. And I am probably going to not choose to do wrestling this year and pick baseball because I have to pick one or the other. But I've been playing sports all my life. I've played, since I can remember, I've played baseball, basketball, football, wrestling. Let's see, what else? Soccer, track, cross country. Like, I'm the kid that chose to do everything unless my parents told me no.
Got it. So you've stayed busy your 4 years at school. What years did you play? Did you do all – is this going to be your first year doing baseball, or did you do
– I did football and wrestling, all three. I played baseball for 2 years.
Okay.
I didn't play baseball last year.
Okay. But you're getting back to it this year.
Yes.
All right. Very cool. So if you look back on your last 4 years at Prairie Ridge, what have been some of your favorite memories that you kind of, when you know, when you're old like me, you'll be looking back and like, oh, that was cool. I enjoyed that.
Well, it's got to be just all the times, and especially like gym class, because my next door neighbor happens to be Coach Peck, and he's yelling at everyone in my neighborhood every day. You got to get outside. You got to do this. You got to do that. You can't be sitting outside on your bum. You got to be outside. Let's go. Let's get some exercise. And in school, if he spots you out in school, he will be saying the same thing. Let's go. You can't be late to class. I will find you, and I will come to your house, and we will have a conversation. And he's such a great guy. I've known him since I was a baby, and he's just been – my parents tell me he's been at me and my brother, especially since we were just little kids. But that's always been great. But also, like, right now, March Madness in school, like, you can talk to all your friends and your teachers about it. It's such a great time.
All right, so March Madness. So who'd you have? Is your bracket, like, busted, or did you get some
completely
kind of four guys?
My bracket is busted completely. I made a couple of brackets with some of my friends and family members. Of course, being where we live, I chose Illinois to win, which got busted. But I have one going right now that I have Baylor beating Gonzaga in the final. So that's my only one left that I have good.
All right. So, well, you've got two out of four. So that's better than I think. I only got one out of four right now. So,
but I was so happy when UCLA beat Michigan last night, because I don't know about anyone else, but Michigan – is my least favorite school out of all.
Is that right?
Yeah.
You're not a Harbaugh fan.
Well, I liked him when he coached the 49ers. So, but Michigan is just not my favorite school in general. So when UCLA beat them last night, I was jumping up and down. I was so excited.
All right. So talking about the future now, what are your plans? Do you know what you're going to do next year, where you want to go, what you want to do, what the future holds?
Well, due to all this COVID stuff, I haven't really thought about it. But right now, my plan is to at least take 1 year at MC, start 1 year at MCC.
Okay.
Because I don't know what I want to do. And I don't want to pay thousands of dollars to go to a college somewhere and sit in a dorm room or sit wherever I am and not go to class, because I want to like experience and not just sit in my room the whole time.
Sure. Got it. So take the opportunity now to introduce us all to your family. Tell us who are the members of your family, your parents, their names, etc.
So my mom and my dad, Jim and Kathy. And then I have a younger brother who's in high school, who's a sophomore named Jimmy. And then I have a little sister that's in seventh grade that goes to Hannah Beardsley named Carly.
Okay, great. You said your brother's a sophomore?
Yes, sir.
So how's that been, the two of you being on a football team together?
Ooh, it depends on the day, I guess. Well, we play the same exact position. Coach O'Neill definitely has a handful every day with the two of us.
Now, why is that?
Well, because me and my brother have always been competitive. We've been playing football together since we were little kids, baseball. We play all the same sports, and we do all the same things. We're about the same height and weight. I'm built more like my dad when he was 140 pounds leaving high school. I'm now 150, 55 pounds, and my brother's about the same.
Okay.
So we've been around the same size our entire lives, playing the exact same sports. So we're always just at each other's throats, competitive every single day.
Got it. Now, if you look back on your 4 years in the classroom, who are those teachers that you've had that have just made a huge impact on you, that you really made their class fun or you really enjoyed your time?
My favorite teacher there, no question, has to either be Mr. Pecoraro or Mr. Baldwin. Mr. Pecoraro won because, like I said earlier, I've known him since I was a little kid, and he's been like – he's like my second father that's just lived right next to me. Like no, not dissing my dad or anything, but, like, he's, like, on all of us in our neighborhood, and, like, his own kids. It's, like, me and my brother especially, like, his, like, other kids. Like, he's always wanting us to be outside. Like, he's encouraging us to be outside. Sends us, like, motivational text messages sometimes. And it's, like, so cool to have because it's such a nice experience because, like, me going in as a freshman, I had his youngest son, David, going as a senior. And, like, I had other people. And, like, he's first day I get into school, him and David come find me. And they're like, this is David. I know you know exactly who he is, but he's going to get you through it your first year, and you're going to get through this together, and then we'll see each other on the baseball field. And it's just been so nice. But other than him, I'd have to say Mr. Baldwin. Mr. Baldwin is probably the funniest teacher I have ever met. He's always tries to make class fun. He always makes class fun because he always is cracking jokes, always like, oh, if you don't do this, it's going to kill your grade. If you don't do this, you're gonna fail my class, and I'll be seeing you next year over the summer. It's just like he tries to scare you, but he does it in like a funny way where everyone understands that, like, he's just a great guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, do you have him? So you had him for English?
Yes. And I have him still right now.
What class do you have him in?
I have him for bestsellers.
Okay. Now, what books did you read in bestsellers?
I'm going to be completely honest. I don't do much reading. I just took it because Mr. Bolden was the teacher.
Well, you had to read something while you're in the class, didn't you?
He said, like, there's this really long book. If you don't pick a book, I'm going to make all you read it. And so he's making us going to make us start reading it once we get back from spring break.
Well, you got to pick a shorter book for yourself that you'd enjoy then, you know?
That's true, but I don't know what I would enjoy because, like, I don't read much because I'm never inside. Like, everyone asks me, like, all my friends text me all the time, yo, like, you want to hop on some video games? You want to, like, do you want to do this? Do you want to do that? I'm never, like, on my phone. I'm never, like, playing video games. I'm always outside.
So all that peck encouragement wore off on you.
Yeah.
I could picture Coach Peck on during COVID walking around the neighborhood with a bullhorn telling everyone to get outside.
Oh yeah. Pots and let's just see. What has he had? Pots and pans. He's done lots of things before. But I can remember because we have in my neighborhood, we got, like, a bunch of, like, still little kids, but, like, kids that are older. But when I was younger, like, we had, like, 20, 30 kids at one time all hanging out outside. And then we all were all going to go. It was like a summer day, and we were all going to go in at like 7 o'clock, eat dinner, and then we were just going to call it a night. Before we were all about to go in, Mr. Pecoraro comes outside, and he just gets in his loud, booming voice, "If none of you come back outside, I'll be at your front doors with pots and pans until you come outside. And I don't want your parents to kill me, but they all know who I am. So if you all don't come back outside when you're all done eating, there's going to be some problems." So then everyone else came back outside, and then I believe that night we were out to like 10 or 11. It was a great night.
You guys probably had some intense wiffle ball games.
Oh, wiffle ball games, kickball games, basketball, you name it, anything. We played everything.
Would Coach Peck play with you guys?
When he was younger, yes, before he would say every day, "Come on, Coach, let's go play." "Oh, I can't anymore. You see, like, I got this bad back."
You know,
I'm not as good as I used to be. I used to be a freak of an athlete, but not anymore.
Yeah, no, he was. So he's not lying, probably. So, all right. So Mr. Baldwin and Coach Peck are obviously two influences. When you look back on kind of the 4 years at PR, what are some great other memories that you're just gonna have?
Well, like, especially if we're going football. Homecoming football games or senior nights, like, those are so cool. And like, I can't, like, well, we obviously don't get to experience homecoming games this year, but like, my freshman, sophomore year, and junior year, like, especially sophomore and junior year, watching like the varsity games and like even just being on the sidelines for those, it's so memorable because you always remember, because like, everyone's so excited, and like, all the super fans and like, whatever the category is, it's just so cool to see all those people. Even like now, when last week's game against South, when we just had a few super fans, but like, you could hear them all, and they were still doing all their chants, and like, it was so nice to finally have fans too.
Yeah, it was nice having that home opener and having some school spirit out there.
Yeah, it's like one of the coolest experiences ever for sports for me, have to be, is like the senior nights and the homecoming games.
No, awesome. So what are you looking forward to here in your last 2 months at PR as a senior?
Honestly, I'm just looking to get it over with. I want to be done and then have a few months to just calm down, figure out what I want to finally do for college, and then move on with my life. I'm ready for high school to be over.
Was it a little, I imagine last year has been pretty taxing and stressful on everything.
Oh yeah. No, hard to get college visits, hard to like get outside, hard to do anything. No sports, no nothing.
What?
It's been tough.
So what have been those things? What have you learned about yourself? What have been those things that you've really enjoyed or found yourself doing during that time?
Honestly, like, talking to people that I haven't talked to in a while, because during like the quarantine and stuff, like, I ended up playing a little bit of video game with some friends I didn't talk to in a while, and like some cousins I hadn't seen in forever because of COVID. And just like doing some new things, like, me and my brother like started like creating our own little games at home. Like, me and like my sister was like still finishing soccer, and so like, we'd be playing indoor soccer with her when my parents weren't home, and like doing some fun things just inside the house because we couldn't get outside.
Sure.
I actually think the quarantine was probably the most fun I've had with my two siblings, even though I hate them sometimes. Most fun I've had with them probably my whole life.
Oh, that's nice. So there was a positive that came out of it on that front, at least. So.
Yeah. Yeah.
Any family traditions start up during that time? Anything you guys started doing, especially in the heart of when all this happened last spring?
Well, me, my brother and sister, we always try to do like something outside every day, just the three of us. Cause like, my parents in the beginning wouldn't let us hang out with anyone else, which we all understood.
Yep.
But like, not really any family traditions, but we try to like play board games and stuff, and like play like sports outside. Like, we taught my, not really taught, but like, got my sister better at catching the ball for, like, she's like, all these boys talk about how football's so hard, but it looks so easy to me. And, like, it was funny because when she first started trying to catch a football and, like, try to run routes, it's just – it was funny watching her, like, fall sometimes and, like, let the ball just hit her straight in the face. Or it was fun.
Now, did you mentioned you got into some video games. Were there any video games that you really enjoyed?
To be honest, not really, because I'm not the video game type of person. I can't just sit down for like even 20 minutes and like do the same thing. I'm not like, I don't really like, it's not that I don't like playing video games, because like if I'm like playing with like my friends or something, like I find it fun, but like I don't like just like sitting down for like hours at a time. Like I used to as a kid. But it's just not my thing anymore, because now that, like, I've been outside all the time playing sports and doing all this stuff with my neighbors, I don't really have time for video games anymore. So I just, like, I don't really care for them anymore.
Got it. Now, how about I'm assuming that there were certain fast food places or restaurants that became very popular during quarantine. So what were some of the Stone family favorites?
Well, not really favorites, but, like, I guess, like, if me and my brother were home by ourselves and we wanted to get something fast before mom and dad get home, it was either Taco Bell or McDonald's. But if we wanted, like, something, like that we both, like, really liked, we'd probably go to, like, Subway or, like, we both really like Buffalo Wild Wings. We would get that to go all the time.
Okay. Now, were there any binge watching? I know you said you're not into being able to watch stuff and you can't sit still, but are there any shows or any things that you checked out, especially when the weather was cruddy?
My brother started watching this show called All American. It's called a football show. It's a football show about this one kid that transfers schools. I thought it was pretty cool, but I just mostly watched sports when they were on. But that's pretty much it.
So when you're talking about sports, obviously there's been a lot of it's been a weird year for that too. So what have been some of, so have you gone back and watched old YouTube videos of different sports games or what sports have you enjoyed watching on TV the most?
Well, definitely now would be March Madness, 100%. It's one of my favorite things every single year. And when last year it got canceled I was so upset. It got canceled 2 days before they were about to announce the tournament. So I was so upset. So, but like all the time with like my brother and my dad, we'd be watching like the 2019 games like over, and like we'd watch like, I remember we watched, we found like old videos, I believe it was of the Blackhawks, like 2015 Stanley Cup. So we went back on YouTube and like watched like the old games and watched it. It was fun.
No, that sounds like it. So I'm guessing you were up late watching the end of the Michigan UCLA game and hoping Michigan didn't score on those last three tries.
Yep.
I know anything you really took for granted, kind of with the way you didn't get to go to school. Are you going back to school now or are you?
I am. Yes.
Okay. So you're back full time. So did you take anything for granted kind of being away from school?
I definitely took for granted, like being at home and like, cause of course, like most kids, I was one of those kids that would like pay attention and take notes, but like, I'd also, if I had a class at 8:45, I'd roll out of bed at 8:43, throw on a sweatshirt, turn on Zoom, and then get to class, and then eat breakfast in the middle of some of my classes, and like then I would like lose like some like notes that I took or something. So I definitely took that for granted, because then when I got back to school, it hit me like, oh my, I have to start paying attention now like fully. So because now I'm right in front of my teacher now, so I got to get it all done.
Got it. Picture now, it is 10 years from now, right?
Okay.
What would be like that dream job for you? What would be the ideal thing that, man, I would just be in heaven doing this? I would love doing this kind of work.
Probably either like a sports writer or like a, like something with sports management.
Okay. Okay. So, because it just comes across that you've just got a passion for athletics.
Yes.
And I could just see you being lifelong in it and wanting it to be a part of it and,
yes,
and such. So, when you say sports manager, is there a part of sports that would be like ideal? Like if you could wave a magic wand and make it happen?
I don't know. Like I'd probably want to be like part of like some big sports organization. Like, but I don't know. Like, I don't know what team it would be for, but like, I'd want to be do something like that. But I definitely want to, wouldn't want to be like a head coach or something because like that's too much for me. But like, so I want to be like a part of something.
So you want to be like in the back office and kind of just be involved with an organization or yeah, something like that.
Yeah.
Do you have a preference if you'd like it to be professional sports or college sports or what would it be?
Either, I think it'd be pretty cool. If I was given an opportunity for either, I think I would take it.
Okay.
But if it was definitely like, if I was like given something for college and then something professional, I'd probably take professional.
All right. Well, it sounds like we know where we're going to see you end up here in a few years.
Hopefully.
Starting at some ticket office somewhere or something like that and working your way up. And
we'll see.
Yeah. Awesome. You've heard the phrase once a wolf, always a wolf, right?
Yeah.
What does that mean when you hear that?
Like, to me, that means like once you walk in the front doors as a freshman, because that's what I was told. Once you walk in the doors as a freshman and once you leave, you join the wolf pack. And once you leave the doors on your last day of a senior, you're still a part of it. Like, we have a freshman on our starting varsity team named John Fallow. I was talking to him the other day. I said, because he's a great football player and he's just a freshman. He's starting on our varsity team. He's a great athlete. And I was talking to him the other day. And I said, John, I cannot wait till I come back here one day when you're a junior and a senior and you're tearing it up out here. Because he's just a freshman and he's got to be one of the better players on our defense. He's a great athlete and a great football player.
Oh, awesome. Awesome. Now, you bring it up. You went to Hannah? Is that where you
yes,
went?
Yes, correct.
Okay. So if you have the opportunity to talk to an eighth grader graduating Hannah this year, what would you say to them? What would be a word of advice, word, you know, some wisdom as they're entering Prairie Ridge next year? What would you encourage them to do or be like?
Don't take freshman year for granted. Try every single year because like me, I decided not to try my very hardest freshman year and part of sophomore year, and it screwed me over in the end. You got to try it as hard as you can all 4 years, every single day to get the best grades you possibly can.
Oh, okay. So you were a little frustrated. You wish you would have taken your studies a little bit more seriously when you started?
Yeah.
No.
Because I always said to myself, oh, I still got 3 years. Oh, I still got that. I still got that. And what do you know? Now it's senior year and it's almost over.
Yeah. Yeah, got it. No, that's awesome. So great words of advice there. Now, you said your sister's in seventh grade?
She is, yes.
And so now if you're going to talk to your sister, what are you going to tell her to look forward and to do?
Carly, make sure you don't fall into the wrong crowd. Make sure no boys until college, and make sure you get your grades up and keep your grades up so you can play sports.
No boys till college. I'm sure she loved hearing that from you.
Oh, she hears it from my dad every day, and I only said that because he's right in front of me.
That's awesome. So I'm sure Carly's not going to be liking the video, but
yeah, she's giving me the dirty look right now.
And she's going to appreciate the big brothers watching over her shoulder and stuff.
Yeah.
So, hey, great job. I appreciate you taking the time and wish you nothing but the best of luck here in the next couple months and in the future.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Miko. Have a good day.
Mama, no, I'm here in this big city where